Hey boys, hey girls. So what is JB up to today? I'm popping some cracklings from Rudolph Foods. And hold up. And so far, I done popped about, maybe this is the raw product. It's called a pellets. They sell them in a 10-pound bag. And really, that's too much to put in at once. So we're going to put those three in the hotter oil. There we go. And you got to weight them down. See, I bent this thing here to hold them under the oil. While they pop in. It takes about a minute to do this. And, you know, down in Mexico and other places, they'll eat these things with their meal instead of bread. And this is probably about maybe not even a quarter of a pound, maybe an eighth of a pound that I've already cracked, or rendered is the proper word. And they're delicious. You call them chirons, chia chirons, cracklings, gratons, pigskins. They go by all kind of names depending on where you at. And you seen them little them four little things about that big I put in there. Watch them in just a minute here. See how they coming along? So let's go ahead and get these out. The fat. And I see one that didn't puff up all the way. See this one right here? It'll be good when you eat it. But it's just gonna be extra crunchy. Be like a hard crackling. See it right there? So what we do with them, you take them off of here and dump them on a little thingy and you season them. It's your favorite dry seasoning. Today I'm playing with all different kinds. I got this Heaven Made product right here. Cajun season all, and you see this one gonna be extra crispy. So we'll give it to the dog; she'll love it. Gonna make some up. Okay, here's the last one I had on that plate, and that is all puffed up, perfect and beautiful. See it moving. As it's cooling down. So get it out to Earl. And we'll sprinkle some seasoning all on that. And put them in a big Ziploc bag or a big bag or some type. Put a couple paper towels to absorb some grease off of them. And continue. And all will still be good. Matter of fact, it'll be delicious for frying chicken in or anything you want fried. So, well, I ain't got a good kitchen light on, right? Studio lights are all off. I've been listening to some movie theme songs. And some of them are fantastic. The ones by Jerry Goldsmith and what's that other? There's a bunch of good composers out there. I think Jerry Goldsmith is one of my favorites. And some movies, even B-rated movies, had fantastic composers to make the songs. What's your favorite movie theme song? You know, a lot of them come to mind. Maybe Patton. That's a really good one. I think that's by John Goldman. I think so. He was a composer. I may have it wrong. I'll caption over because I've got it. The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly. There's a bunch of them. There's a bunch of them. There's a bunch of them. What's that other one? The Final Countdown. It's got an excellent soundtrack on it. MASH. You know, so what's your favorite movie theme song? You know, being a musician and all, and playing in orchestra or concert band, stage band, that kind of thing, and rock bands. Yeah, I've been playing drums for about 50 years, but I'm retired from that now. I like the movie theme songs that are more orchestra-based. That's just me, the musician, the creative JB coming out. And I guess I'm pretty creative. Huh, boy. I'm gonna go finish popping some more cracklings up. Rendering some more cracklings. We'll have them as snacks, breakfast, for bread. Instead of bread, with a meal. You can bust them up and put them on a hamburger. Or bust them up and put them in a salad. Put them whole on a hamburger. Use them instead of lettuce. You know, that green shit.
It tastes like a more healthy bacon. Yum.
Let's talk in the comments. What's your favorite movie soundtrack? I'm not going to try to do a poll because it don't work on all devices, and I can't put this movie, that many, you know, like 100 movies in there to select from, so whatever. Let's have some fun. What am I cooking tonight? I don't know. Got all kind of stuff. Got crawfish, I got shrimps, I got hamburger meat, I got steaks. I kind of feel like a Oklahoma burger. May make them. I may shoot a video, I may not. Just take some stills. It's kind of like an overgrown slider. That's all it is. A bigger slider, normal hamburger bun size, with a half an onion on each burger, you know, that's been put on the griddle and juicy and delicious. Show you some pictures of that. No green shit on mine, though. Sorry. Now I'm frying down what's known as tender cracks. And they actually got... Come here, dog. They got more meat on them. But they still got meat on them. See the little white pocket there? Watch, let me grab you one. That is that cooked up. We got meat on them. Called tender crack. And the other ones are called pigskin. That's the ones that get real big. Over there. Look back over there. But they all got to be weighted down under the earl. They only take about a minute a batch. And these don't expand as much as the full-fledged pigskins do. These are like the ones you buy in the store, made by major brands. Gonna put them all up in here and then season them. Another batch. Maybe a little too much. No.
Yeah, you can get the pellets at Rudolph Foods website.
To season them.
And they're good for you, too. The real cracklings, what do you call them now? And these are cut from the pork belly. There's a pork belly right there. And when we fry these up, these take a long time to do, about 3 or 4 hours. We call them gratins, but they are super rich, super fatty, and you can't eat too many. Anyway, I made some sliders, oversized sliders, giant size. Mash them down one time, and don't mash them down no more. That's on the griddle. We're going to cook down, sweat down some onions, which I've been playing with, and put the burgers on top. Both sides have been seasoned, so are the onions. And through the magic of, I forgot to start the camera for this step, the cheese that goes on and the buns. Miss JB wanted cheese. I didn't want no cheese on mine. So cover them up and let it smother and warm. Steam the buns. There's Miss JB's with some white American cheese. Put anything you want on. I mean, ketchup, mustard, mayonnaise. Don't matter. And eat them. I like them with chiwis. Yum.
New keyboard I got here, man. Function, which one makes the lights go up and down? There you go. You know, I'm getting old and hard of seeing. And hard of hearing and hard of headed, too. So, and it's a mechanical keyboard. Yeah. Made with aircraft aluminum. Military-grade aircraft aluminum. And it's waterproof. And I like the way you can get up on there and just makes a cool sounds like the old style keyboards did. JB. Oops, what'd I do? Hey. Don't argue with me. So I type in stereo with two fingers. See that? Move all this out the way. There's a video I'm editing on. And you can make it do breathing stuff. How you do that? Function. Yeah, let me turn the lights off. That's when it gets really cool. It'll breathe for you. Now, wee. Who is made by again? I forget. I gotta look at the damn thing. It's only about $40. Eagle Tech. Now, I love the backlighting on this one. My old one had backlighting too, but it was going out after about, 5 years or so. And you can turn them off. You can just flat out dim them and turn the breathing off. Do all kind of different things with the function key. See, FN, right there.
Now, who remembers the Thirsty Birds? The one on the right is, he real old. And part of his he don't work as fast as that alcoholic looking one on the left with them googly eyes. This must be the old man version here. He's just old. And this is a brand new one. Miss JP got me at the store. You just drinking too much there, Blue Hat. Yeah. There go Papa. Look, he's starting to lean over now. This is a cool old kid's toy. Alright, we fitting a wean you. Okay, you have to stay over there now. And just watch Papa. He's going to show you how to do it. You thirsty, Papa? Little bit? Good. Got a big old snoot on him, don't he? He got a little, woodpecker looking snoot there. The Thirsty Birds. You can get them online. It's a kid's toy. Oh, you come up dry, huh?
Too bad, boy.
A boy, a girl, a bird.